I'm just blessed. You know, I'm blessed. You know, anybody that's in the Forbes magazine, you know, is blessed. You know, I'm just thankful, very appreciative. I can, you know, I couldn't do it without the family and team support. From
it really does reflect on the entire organization, doesn't it? Something's being done right, and maybe whether promotions and without having them with what, right? I mean, it's almost like a team award kind of thing. I mean, you look at the
well,
top of your
name. Well, you know, I'm just a fighter slash promoter.
Right.
Just trying to get back to the sport of boxing. It's all about giving back to the sport of boxing. If I'm in a position to give back.
Mm-hmm. Is that what this weekend's card is about, helping promote it? You got a lot of your fighters on the card.
I mean, I'm just happy that, you know, that we're able to work together in a positive way. I think we've done a remarkable job. Al Heyman has done a remarkable job. And it's all about chemistry. I think we have unbelievable chemistry.
Physically, how do you feel? Could you have the transfer fight today? Could you be in the gym? Are you physically
good? I probably weigh one.
No, but my point is you came out of the fight very well, right? Physically.
Yeah.
That's what kind of way I was saying.
Yeah, I feel like mom. You know, it's
sure.
Like I always feel.
Yeah.
I've been real busy, actually, making appearances, a lot of appearances. Where I've been. Been a few places. Mm-hmm.
Did you enjoy the finals?
Sports fight a lot.
I love basketball.
Were you surprised the Golden State won, or did you think LeBron could single-handedly hopefully put to the title?
You know, every year, you know, when you're in the betting world, you have a certain team that you ride with. I've been riding with the Golden State Warriors from the beginning. I think when Durant was 100% OKC,
yes.
I was riding with them. I was winning a lot of money with them. LeBron James is the best basketball player in the world. Probably the best basketball player of all time. But Golden State Warriors are the best team in the NBA. So it's hard for one man to beat a team. When I take my hat off to LeBron James, remarkable athlete, unbelievable athlete, great guy. You know, I know how social media could be. You know, they with you today, they hate you tomorrow, they talk about you tomorrow, then the next day, when you win, they right back riding the bandwagon.
You're right.
So, I think Stephen Curry is probably the best, you know, Stephen Curry is probably the best shooter of all time. Kevin Durant is the best scorer of all time. And I said, LeBron James is probably the best player of all time.
You're old, don't you remember Michael Jordan?
Yeah, I was around.
They're different players.
Yeah, I watch.
And different eras.
I think it's different eras.
It is.
You know, I just, like, me and Stephen A. Smith was having a talk about different basketball players. And You know, when I look at certain basketball players, it's really just an opinion. But if we're going by numbers, then, I mean, but I cannot leave Kobe Bryant. You know, we're talking about Durant, Stephen Curry, LeBron James, but we're talking about Michael Jordan, we cannot leave Kobe Bryant out. And you can, it's an argument also with that situation. Because he could, you could say he's the best.
It's a lot like the boxing argument, guarding you all the time.
Of course. And I commend.
You never try to compare yourself to another guy from a different era. I know. You're worried about that.
Yes. I mean, but it's totally different. It's totally different. There's no disrespect to no fighter, you know, that's in the past that paved the way for me to be where I'm at, you know. It's none but respect. I just feel I'm the best.
Can you explain how you got this gym? How did you come to own this gym and train here?
It's kind of... I think I left top ring, dude.
No, we just... the other spot. You say, I'm out. We gotta get a new spot.
I was training at a good gym. Oh, the Berries is a nice gym. I was training at Berries.
And then how'd you get here? You want your office?
We probably made some calls around. And I had to go. I had to come physically to look at the property. And when I came here, I looked. I said, okay, it's a nice place. I said, our company is getting bigger. I'm getting bigger. Let's knock the wall down. So we knocked the wall down. And then,
you give your guys tough cash, right?
And then we said, we're growing. So let's knock the wall down. Knock the wall down again.
Hey, Floyd, Speedy from the Richie Menace Show in New York City. You're speculating about retirement and all this. Can anybody carry boxing after you?
You got two guys this weekend. Adrien, Broner, Errol Spence. Those guys, don't do that. Don't come in my gym and be disrespectful. Either you want to be here or you don't.
I just think that you're the best possible.
Yeah, but in this gym, it's respect. Positive. We, how the sport grows, we stay positive. You know, we can't grow being negative. You know, that's like, you know, we can't grow being negative. It takes a lot. It takes a lot to get to this point. The ultimate goal is to, first, it takes a lot to get to this point. You can't just be able to fight. You gotta be able to know how to communicate, have certain charisma. The guys, they have the right team. They have the right team. They continue to win. We bring that personality out, those guys. And then we'll see where we can go from there.
But I think there was only two showmen in boxing, three showmen. You, Hector Camacho, and Muhammad Ali. But to me, you three guys are the only guys that really showed boxing.
Well, we cannot be biased because you're Puerto Rican. Hector Camacho was a legend. You know, he was one hell of a fighter. You know, Ali, Sugar Ray Robinson. I mean, and the list goes on and on. We never talk about Ann Pryor.
Yeah, from Cincinnati.
I'm just saying, those are the guys that when I used to watch it. It's Hawk time. What time is it? It's Hawk time.
Yeah. Two great fights, him and Alexis Arguello.
We'll never talk about Alexis Arguello. You know, those are the guys, you know. Michael Dokes, you know those.
Dynamite, Michael Dokes.
Yeah, I mean, those are the guys that I remember. I mean, my personal, it's just my opinion. I think Larry Holmes was probably.
Oh, he was a great fighter too.
One of the best.
When you take Adrien and you consider him, I mean, how much of his talent is he getting out? I mean, it seems like he's more talented than he actually
performs in the ring. Well. You take my fighter, What's up, little guy? We got so many fighters.
Memphis?
No. The kid that
Chris Pierce.
The one that got knocked out. But he champion now.
Pardew, yeah.
No, the other.
Mickey Bay.
The same guy that Mickey Bay lost to. The same guy that gave the guy, what's the guy that's a big puncher?
Batiste.
You see the difference? How Adrien Broner handled the guy.
You mean Maidana? Broner?
No, I'm talking about Molina. Adrien Broner facing Maidana. How he got up, kept fighting, showed a lot of heart. Showed a lot of heart, tremendous heart. Because with me fighting Maidana, I mean, of course, with me having so much experience, I know how to handle any and every type of style, and, you know, facing different opponents. Adrien Broner, if I was in his corner, I probably would have stopped the fight before he could live on him, because you have a career. You still have a long career. And a fight like that can take a lot out of a fighter. Because I care about a fighter's well-being because I'm a fighter. When I was young, when I was 24, 25, I'd be like, when a trainer stops a fight, you get upset. When a trainer throws a white towel in, fighter get upset. I'm like, I used to tell my corner, you better never throw a towel in on me. But you got to think about your career, longevity. But with me fighting Maidana, he punched like he got steel in his glove.
What do you want people to remember about you?
The main thing, as long as my kids remember, as long as my family remember, that's what's important when it's all said and done. Because fans, they move on to the next. You know, they can be with you today. Same thing like with LeBron. You got fans that's going on social media. They got on his sneakers and talking bad about him. So, I mean, you live and you learn. I mean, my thing is family. That's what's important to me. As I get older and as I get wiser, family.
Just to fucking on the follow up on what you're saying about Adrien, you were in there against Maidana, and you know how serious of an opponent he is. So
when Adrien is fighting him, you get the
hump in him in the corner. Like, how
seriously can you be taking the fight if you're doing that kind of shit during the fight, right? Don't you have to have 100% of your focus on fighting him and not doing that other shit? That's why I play a major key.
That's not
happening. Normally, his training camp is in Cincinnati, where there's a lot of distractions. What happened? I got on the phone with him. Get here. We need you here where there's no distractions. And he's still going to make a lot of mistakes because he's young. No different from me. I made a lot of mistakes. But I didn't have a mentor like a Floyd Mayweather to communicate and tell me right from wrong.
Do you see a difference in him today? And do you think we'll see a difference in him on Saturday against Sean Porter and then you saw in his previous couple fights?
Well, I think that it's a lot that he still have to learn. To whereas when Leonard Ellerbe is on the podium talking about the fighters, you know, Adrien has to realize he can't just praise him. In the promotion world, we have to be on an even playing field. No different from what we talked about in the past about the Mayweather-Pacquiao fight. Only thing I wanted to be was on an even playing field. So, Sean Porter has been champion before. So we can't just talk. This guy only has one loss. And Adrien Broner has one loss. So I think it's a good matchup.
If he takes it as seriously as you take it, or close to that seriously, how good can he be?
He could be a pay-per-view star. You know, a lot of times fighters, when they get in the business. When they get in the business, fighters first they say, you know what? I'm gonna be world champion. I want to make a lot of money. At one particular time, they wanted to be on a certain network. But then, of course, Mayweather, I come in, I change the game. It's all about the small guys now. Not taking anything away from the heavyweights, but I changed the sport of boxing. I done something in the sport of boxing. No fighter in history has ever done, and probably will never do. Whereas, nothing against the Klitschko's or no other heavyweight, but this era of boxing is all about Mayweather. And I've been around a long time. I've been around a very, very long time. But as far as with Adrien Broner, he's super talented.
You talk about Errol Spence, because Errol Spence, a lot of people don't know him yet, but you've been around him for a while, so what do you see on that?
Well, this is what happened. You know, I call a spade a spade. I was, you know, I'd done time. So when I was locked away, when I came out, you know, I was still off a little while. When I came back to the gym, I wasn't boxing, you know, orthodox fighters. The guys that I was boxing, because my fight, instantly under my contract, was with
Robert
Guerrero, so he was a southpaw. So my first guy to start sparring was a southpaw. So he was giving me good work, real good work. And he pushed me, he made me get in tip-top condition. And when I got in tip-top condition, I was Floyd Mayweather. But he's a hell of a fighter.
So he was very instrumental in helping you sharpen up?
Yes, absolutely. But it's gonna take a little bit more. And me and Errol Spence talk. Where he at? Where is it? Where
Errol Spence?
He's in the meeting.
He's still working?
Yeah.
We talk, and we're looking forward to, I think that his next fight, I think, was a good matchup, is
Keith Thurman.
I think that should be a championship fight. I think him and Keith Thurman should fight for a title, his next fight. He's ready. I got belts I would like to relinquish that I haven't yet relinquished, and I haven't yet got my WBO belt. You know, I haven't yet. If I can relinquish something, I have to receive it.
So Bradley Barbers are not fighting for that belt.
I'm just saying.
I'm not getting into the politics of it, but everybody knows.
I'm just saying. I've yet to receive my.
Just won the belt.
I've yet to receive my WBO belt. So, once again, I was on the podium. I said, this week, you know, I believe that I would like to relinquish my belts, and I want to relinquish my belts, however it may came out. But I still get to receive my BO belt. So how is somebody fighting for something that I'm yet to receive?
Hey.
I asked Jesse that Monday. He says, I don't know what's going on.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, @EllieSecback.